himself with a guest stateroom. When she went to guest services to remedy the situation, guest services asked the lady if she would like an inside or an outside stateroom. She replied, well, it looks like it might rain, so I should probably get an inside stateroom.
After seeing their stateroom on boarding day, a newlywed couple stormed down to guest services to complain. The bride was in tears and the groom was furious. When asked what was wrong, the groom replied, we booked a stateroom with an ocean view, and all we can see is the parking lot.
This morning, a stateroom attendant was assisting a frustrated guest to his suite. What a day, said the guest. I woke up this morning, I put on my shirt, the button fell off. I opened up the dresser, the knob fell off. I picked up my suitcase, the handle fell off. I'm afraid to go to the bathroom.
Les Cruz, at the bottom of the customs declaration form where it says, sign here, a guest wrote, Capricorn.
Last week, my stateroom attendant knocked on my door, asked if he could come in and clean up. I said, sure, come on in. So he entered, took a shower, and left. How many art auctioneers does it take to screw in a light bulb? One. Do I hear two? How about three?
A lady approached me last night and asked if we have church services on board. I replied, yes, we do, as a matter of fact. We have church services every day in the casino. Really, she said, what denomination? Usually tens and twenties.
Last week, an older gentleman was sat by the pool. He sat in the same place every single day. It was fairly obvious from his Rolex watch and his expensive jewelry that he was a very wealthy man. A crew member went up to him and asked him how he made his money. The gentleman said, well, son, it was 1932, the depth of the Great Depression. I was down to my last nickel. I invested that nickel in an apple. I spent the entire day polishing that apple, and at the end of the day, I sold it for 10 cents. The next morning, I invested those 10 cents into two apples. I spent the entire day polishing them and sold them at 5 o'clock for 20 cents. I continued this system, and by the end of the month, I had accumulated $1.38. Then my wife's father died and left us $2 million.
A guest went into the gift shop and asked if they had anything for hiccups. Without warning, the retail associate slapped him in the face. What was that for? He yelled. Well, you don't have hiccups anymore, do you? Replied the assistant. I never did, he replied. It was my wife.
A lady was looking through the spa treatments on deck 9 and saw they offered milk baths. What is a milk bath? She asked the therapist. Well, she said, you soak in a tub full of warm milk. It promotes a smoother, creamier complexion. Is it pasteurized? She asked. No, it just goes up to your neck.
The shop manager was woken up at 3 a.m. this morning by a drunk guest wanting to know when the liquor store was opening. The shops will open at 10 a.m. and I'll be glad to let you in, replied the manager. The guest replied, I don't want to get in, I want to get out.
During dinner today, a guest asked the waiter for a burger without onions. The waiter said, I'm sorry, sir, we're out of onions. Perhaps I could bring it without pickles instead. A guest went up to the Windjammer manager today to complain about the waiters in the buffet. The manager said he was truly apologetic as his waiters pride themselves on their efficiency. That's the problem, the guest replied. They are too efficient. I put my lunch on the table, I went to get a glass of tea, I came back, my lunch had gone. I went to get more lunch, came back, and my tea had gone. I'm standing in a room full of food and I'm starving. 5 ways to know you have overdone it at the buffet.
You cut your finger and gravy pours out.
Your picture in the photo gallery says continued on other side.
You go to a restaurant and instead of a menu, they give you an estimate.
You step on a talking scale and it says one at a time, please.
You get in an elevator and it only goes down. A guest asked the chef, how do you prepare the chickens? The chef replied, we just tell them straight out, they are going to die.
Why do seagulls fly over the sea? Because if they flew over the bay, they'd be bagels.
Why did the cookie visit the ship's doctor? Because he felt crummy.
What is bright orange and sounds like a parrot? A carrot.
Why was the tomato red? Because it saw the salad dressing.
What do you get when you eat beans and onions? Tear gas.
What's the difference between roast beef and pea soup? Anyone can roast beef.
Did you hear about the new garlic diet? You don't lose weight, but you look thinner from a distance.
Last night at 2 a.m., the ship's security officer noticed a drunk gentleman sneaking down the hallway. What are you doing out this late at night, sir? Asked the security officer. I'm going to a lecture, the guest replied. Really? The security officer asked. And who is going to be giving a lecture at this late hour? My wife.
A guest was having a late-night drink in the schooner bar two nights ago when he heard a high-pitched voice say, "Nice shirt!" He looked around and couldn't see anybody, except for him and the bar server. A few minutes later, he hears that same voice again. This time it says, "Nice tie!" He looked around, sees nothing, just him and the bar server. Then a few seconds later, he hears that same voice again, this time saying, "Nice hairstyle!" He calls over the bar server and explains he keeps hearing voices saying nice things. The bar server replies, "Don't worry, sir. That's the peanuts. They're complimentary."
A guest goes up to a Chinese bar server and says, "Give me a stoli with a twist." The bar server thinks for a second, smiles and says, "Okay. Once upon a time, there were three little piggies." How much do pirates pay for their earrings? A buccaneer.
What lies at the bottom of the ocean and twitches? A nervous wreck.
A Czechoslovakian waiter goes to the ship's doctor to get his eyes tested. The doctor points at the wall chart and asks him if he can read the bottom line. Okay. H, L, K, V, C, Z, M. Hey. I know that guy.
The hotel director went into the office this morning and found the captain standing next to the paper shredder with a piece of paper. He asked, "Can I help you, Captain?" He said, "Yes, I have a very important document here and I can't get this thing to work. Can you help me?" "Certainly, sir." Then he turned on the machine, pressed the start button. "Great," said the captain as the paper disappeared into the machine. "I just need one copy."
A cruise director and a guest were kidnapped last week by rebels. The rebels decided to shoot them. But before they did, they granted them each one last request. The rebel leader asked, "What about you?" The guest replied, "Yes, I do have one last request. I've always loved the electric slide. Please could we do the electric slide one last time?" The rebel leader agreed. Then he said to the cruise director, "What about you? What is your final request?" The cruise director said, "Please kill me first."
So true. A couple were talking in the bar last night. "Darling, if I died, would you get married again?" "Definitely not," replied the man. "You don't like being married?" "Of course I do." "Then why wouldn't you get married again?" "Oh, okay, I'd get married again." "Would you let her sleep in our bed?" "Where else would she sleep?" "Would you let her cook in my kitchen?" "Where else would she cook?" "Would you let her use my golf clubs?" "Of course not. She's left-handed."
A guest walked into Bolero's last night, sits down and orders a scotch. He swigs it down, looks in his pocket, cringes, and then orders another one. He gulps it down, looks in his pocket again and cringes again. He then orders another one. After a couple of hours, the bartender says, "I know it's none of my business, but I have to ask, what do you keep looking at in your pocket?" "That's a picture of my wife," the guest says. "I drink until she starts to look good, then I know it's time for me to go back to my cabin."
A A guest was walking on deck 10 this morning when her glass eye fell out and rolled down the stairs. A man grabbed it and brought it back to her. She thanked him and asked if he'd like to join her for dinner tonight. That's very nice, he said, but do you ask every man you meet to dinner? No, she said, only those who catch my eye.
An elderly couple last night had just watched the Love and Marriage game show, and the wife winks at her husband and says, let's run upstairs and make whoopee. Her husband replies, you will have to pick one. I can't do both.
And finally on ship news, a couple cruised last week for their 50th anniversary. One afternoon, while her husband was napping, the wife slipped on her black silk negligee. Then she tiptoed over to her husband and whispered in his ear, super sex. Super saints. Her husband opened his eyes and said, I'll have the soup. And that's it for today's ship news. Thank you for tuning in. You stay classy, Enchantment of the Seas.
And it's a good night from me.
And it's a good night from her.
Good night.
Of the Seas. This is the latest edition of Ship News. On boarding day, there was a hello, here is the ship news. Oh, hello, my name is Mark. What do you get when you eat... chickens.